Hi students, welcome back in chapter number 7 of science in getting to know plants. This is the third and last part of the chapter. And in previous session, we had already studied about stems and leaves of the shoot system. Next part of the plant which we are going to study is flower. So let's study about the flower in detail. Flower is mainly the reproductive part of plant. Different parts of flowers are petals, sepals, pistil and stamen. Pistil is the female reproductive part of flower and stamen is the male reproductive part of flower. We will now study about each of these parts in detail. Let's start with the petal first. So the colored part of flower are called as flower petals. You can see in the picture and you also have seen flowers of different colors. These colored part of flowers is called petals. Next is sepals. Sepals are small leaf like structure. That outermost green color part that encloses the bud. You can see in the picture and you must have seen in flowers also the green leaf like structure below petals. These are called sepals. Let's move forward. As I told you that pistil is the female reproductive part of flower and stamen is the male reproductive part of flower. So you can see in the picture clearly pistil and stamens. Let's study about stamen first. Stamen is the male part of flower and the pollen producing part of flower. You can see in the figure 7.23 the stamen and its two parts, anther and filament. The upper part is anther and the lower part is filament. Anther produces pollen grains. Now next is pistil. Pistil is a female part of flower. As I told you earlier, it consists of stigma, style and ovary. You can see in this figure 7.24 the pistil and its parts. Now let's see the ovary. Ovary is the lowermost or swollen part of pistil. If you cut open this ovary, you will notice that there are small bead like structures inside ovary. These small bead like structures inside ovary are called as ovules, as shown in figure. Now we know that pistil is the female reproductive part. It consists of stigma, style and ovary. And stamen is the male reproductive part and it consists of anther and filament. Now we have understood the parts of flower. You can see in the picture also. So what are the parts of flower, students? Yes, petals, sepals, pistil and stamen. Pistil consists stigma, style and ovary. And stamen consists anther and filament. Now let's move forward. We will now try to understand how fertilization happens in a flower. So I told you that anthers are the pollen producing part. So pollen grains are produced in anther and then pollen grains are transferred from these anthers to the stigma of the flower. How? By honeybees, by wind, by houseflies. So when pollen grains are transferred from anther to stigma, pollen grains will travel down through the style and will reach ovary. In ovary, eggs are present and in ovary, pollen grains will fertilize the eggs. And that's how the ovules present in the ovary will turn into seeds and the ovary will turn into fruit. So after fertilization, the ovary will swell. It will gradually become bigger and bigger in size and it will turn into a fruit. Let's look at the example. You can see the mango flower in the picture. So first the pollens from the anthers will be transferred to the stigma of the flower. Then fertilization will happen in the ovary, where the pollen grains will fertilize the eggs present in the ovary, and after the fertilization, the ovary will swell. It will gradually become bigger and bigger in size and it will turn into this delicious mango fruit, and the ovules will turn into seeds. Okay, so this is how the fertilization happens. Now, we will study about roots. Till now we had studied about shoot system, which consists stem, leaves and flowers. Okay. So now roots of the plant. The roots help in holding the plant firmly in the soil. Roots absorb water and minerals from the soil and the stem transports these to other parts of plant. We already know this. Right, that roots absorb water and minerals from the soil and stem transports these to other parts of plant. Next is types of root. There are two types of root, taproot and fibrous root. In this type of root system, there is one prominent and long main root and a bunch of smaller lateral side roots that grow from this main root. Now you can see in the figure A, a long main prominent main root and the side roots or lateral roots are coming out of this. So this type of root system is called as taproots. Okay. Next is fibrous roots. In this type of root system, all the roots emerge directly from the base of the plant. They do not have a main root. Now, see in the figure 7.17b. They do not have a main root and all the roots are directly emerging from the base of the stem. This type of root system is called a fibrous root system. So just by looking at the leaves of plant, can you tell about the kinds of root it has? So answer is yes. How it is possible? How can we know about the roots by just looking only the plants? So the answer is very simple, that if the leaves have reticulate venation, the plants will have taproot system, as I already told you about the reticulate venation, that it has a net like design in leaves. And if the leaves show parallel venation, the plant will have fibrous root system. So, just by the looking at the leaves, you can tell that what kind of roots the plant have. You don't have to dig the soil, you don't remove the plant and then look at the roots and then what kind of root system it has. So you don't have to dig the soil, you don't have to remove the plant from the root to see that what kind of root system it has. Only just by looking at the leaves of the plant, you can tell about the kind of root it has. Now, to understand the functions of roots, you will perform a simple activity. What you have to do is, you have to take two potted plants and you have to remove roots from one of the plant, and after that you have to water the plant regularly and for 7 days. Then after 7 days you observe the plant. You will find that the plant in the pot A with the roots intact, it will stand erect and it will be difficult to pull it out as roots provide support to the plant. The plant will show normal growth and development. Why? Because the roots help in the absorption of water and mineral from the soil. But the plant in the pot B with no roots, it will not stand erect, it will fall and it will easier to pull it out. The plant will eventually die because there are no roots. These are some plants or some trees which have aerial roots also. Like you see in the picture, the banyan tree. Have you seen these kind of roots? These are called as aerial roots. So here I conclude the chapter. All the three parts are completed. Our chapter is completed here. Now, if you have any doubt, then note it down in notebook and be ready for interactive query session. Till then, bye-bye.